स्टूडेंट्स गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल दैन सुखा कीप हेल्थी द पर्सन अंटिल नाउ वी आर लर्न अबाउट द नॉर्मल टैक्स एंड आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी फेमिलियर विद द बैलेंस डाइट एंड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस इन मेंटेनिंग ए हेल्थी लिविंग सो नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू द डाइट थेरापी. डाइट थेरापी इज कंसर्न विद द रिकवरी फ्रॉम इलनेस एंड प्रिवेंशन ऑफ डिजीजेस. इट इज द therapy using diet or food pattern is changed to treat a disease, that is diet therapy. Diet therapy is the branch of dietetics concerned with the use of foods for therapeutic purpose. This is a method of eating foods prescribed by a physician to improve health. Diet therapy usually involves modification of a regular dietary lifestyle, that is until now we have discussed about the normal diet. In the normal diet we are providing nutrients almost equal to the RDA, and you are already familiar or studied very well about the normal diet, and normal diet given to the individuals, healthy individuals, as well as the RDA recommendation by ICMR, the nutritive value, all things are, I think you all of you are familiar. So this is, now we are moving to the diet which is especially modified for suit the particular disease condition or particular health condition. In diet therapy, we are planning diet for every condition. Even it may be an obesity, it may be an undernutrition. Everything we are concerned and we are preparing a diet for them according to their requirements. So that is a diet therapy. And generally, the first thing we have to know is the modification of a normal diet. It is a modification, not we are changing a diet, but we are modifying the normal diet, or we are modifying what the person is consuming. And we are modifying to meet the additional requirement, or we are reducing whatever we want to do, that is we are doing in a normal diet or the lifestyle. So it's a normal diet is defined one which consists of all the foodstuffs in an adequate amount and correct proportion to provide a balanced diet. This is the normal diet. It's a well balanced and nutritionally adequate diet is providing to meet the RDA. That is already we learned, but in diet therapy we are modifying it to suit the particular condition or particular likes and dislikes of a person. But the therapeutic diet is the specially designed for the people suffering from diseases. That is a therapeutic diet. There are many health conditions which is need a diet modification, and when we are specially designing diet to suit the medical condition, that is the therapeutic diet. So, usually therapeutic diets are followed in cardiovascular disease, diabetes and ulcerative colitis, etc. It can be achieved by adding or limiting certain foods in order to improve a specific health condition. It is usually done under the observation of a dietitian in hospitals. It is concerned with the use of food as an agent in affecting recovery from the illness to meet the changing needs of a person. Then diet therapy is concerned about the weight management, detoxification, energy and immunity boost, active body functions and essential nutrients, whereas diet therapy is concerned with the diabetes, cardiovascular disease, ulcerative colitis, etc. So this is the difference between therapeutic diets and the diet therapy. So now we can go into the basics of a diet therapy. General objectives of diet therapy. This is to maintain a good nutritional status, to correct nutrient deficiencies that may have occurred due to the diseases, then to afford rest to the whole body or the specific organ affected by the disease. For example, kidney failure is an example. When kidney failure occurs, we have to give rest to the kidney, so the water consumption and other water intake is restricted. To adjust the food intake to suit the body's ability to metabolize the nutrient during diseases. To bring about changes in body weight whenever necessary. If a person is diabetic and at the same time obese, we do diet therapy to reduce the weight as well as control the diabetic condition. The factors to be considered in planning therapeutic diets. What are the factors we have to keenly observe before planning a diet? First, the disease condition. Though for a diabetic patient with obese and a diabetic patient with a lean body mass, the diet are totally different. So in an obese diabetic patient, we have to reduce the body weight. Otherwise, in a lean person, we have to increase the body weight, but we have to control the carbohydrate content also. So it is concerned about the carbohydrate content in the diet. So we have different diet concepts for these two persons. At the same time, it occurs in the cardiovascular persons, and everything we are observing the body weight and height and the particular disease condition. So each individual, the diet is different if both are in a diabetic situation, but the diet changes according to their body structure, according to their lifestyle, everything change affects the diet. The possible duration of the disease. Of course, in a disease condition, in a fever condition, in a diarrhea condition, it is a diet for a small duration. But in diabetic condition and the cardiovascular condition, it is for lifelong. So we have to prepare a dish or prepare a diet that have to be followed for lifetime for the lifestyle diseases such as diabetic, hypertension and cardiovascular disease. But in the case of fever, diarrhea and that types of diseases, the diet is for a short duration. So there is no chance of deficiency diseases, and it is for a short duration, so we can provide semi-solid, semi-liquid diets can be provided because it is for a short duration. Then the factors in the diet which must be altered to overcome these conditions. For example, in diabetic conditions, we have to alter the carbohydrate intake. But in cardiovascular diseases, we have to alter the carbohydrate content, cholesterol content or the fat content in the diet. When it is concerned about the metabolic disorder, we have to control the specific nutrient, especially most probably it occurs for the protein metabolism, and there is a metabolic disorder, phenylketonuria as an example. In such cases, we have to restrict the protein content of the diet. So it is based on the condition of the patient, the patient's tolerance for food. In that, we are concerned about the vegetarian and non-vegetarian. Some have lactose intolerance. Then we have to completely restrict milk, and it can be provided as the curd or something. Other protein foods should be substituted for milk. So lactose intolerance is an example for tolerant food, and vegetarians and non-vegetarianism is concerned with the food preferences. So it can also be considered while preparing a diet for a patient. Then the patient's economic status, food preferences, occupation, time of meals also should be considered. Occupation, time of meals, if they have a night duty, the time of meal frequently changes based on their occupation. So all this must be considered while we are preparing a diet for a patient. Then we have to provide adequate amount of diet in accurate with accurate nutrients, must be economical and must be palatable, and especially this concern are to be followed in a diet that can be followed for a lifetime or long term diet. All these four factors should be taken into consideration because they have to follow the diet for a long time. Then modification of therapeutic diets, how the therapeutic diets can be modified to suit the disease condition. It is classified into two, qualitative and quantitative, quantitative and qualitative modification. In qualitative modification occurring in the nutrient content. In quantitative modification, there occurs a change in consistency, rearrangement of meals and omission of certain foods. First is the qualitative changes. In qualitative changes, we restrict the nutrients or we give excess of nutrients. Restriction of nutrient occurs in hypertension, diabetics, cardiovascular diseases, etc. We restrict, of course, in metabolic disorders also, restriction of nutrient occurs. But excess of nutrient occurs in tuberculosis and other protein energy malnutrition deficiency diseases, etc. Excess nutrients is provided. In short, qualitative modification can be concluded as calorie. High calorie diet is provided for the underweight person, at the same time deficiency person, high carbohydrate provided, fever case, hyperthyroidism and burns are the situations where high calories provided. In a normal diet, you are already studied, higher carbohydrate is provided through the growth period, that is adolescent period, pregnancy period, lactation period also demands higher carbohydrate content. It also it increases the carbohydrate content. At the same time, in these situations also, carbohydrate content increases. In fever situation, there are higher metabolic rates, so the energy requirement increases. Then low calorie, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, hypertension, gout. Then protein, in the case of protein, the same diabetes and cardiovascular diseases demands more protein, because protein can also be utilized for energy purposes. When we are reducing the calorie, then they have the energy requirement, but enough calorie is not provided. So these proteins are utilized for the energy purposes. So protein content is higher during the hypertension period. For the diabetic patients in the diet, we increases the protein so that this protein can be utilized for the energy needs. And fever and hypothyroidism also demands more protein. Then low protein, hepatic encephalopathy, glomerular nephritis, renal failure and metabolic disorder demands low protein content. Then fat content, atherosclerosis, a type of cardiovascular diseases, and myocardial infarction is also a kind of cardiovascular disease. In both cases, fat should be reduced. All this occurs due to the fat deposit in the blood vessels, and this can be reduced by reducing the fat content. High fat content is provided in severe malnutrition conditions, especially hypovitaminosis and vitamin A deficiency. Also, severe undernutrition occurs. Fat content is increased to maintain the healthy condition. Then sodium hypernatremia is the deposit of sodium. In that cases, the sodium content is lower than the required amount, so that conditions high sodium is provided. Low sodium, heart failure, hypertension and renal failure, low sodium is provided. Then fiber content, diarrhea, ulcerative colitis, partial intestinal obstruction, etc., high fiber diet is provided. In constipation and diverticulosis, low fiber diet is provided. Then quantitative modification is carried out by changing consistency, rearrangement of meals and omission of foods. First, we can consider the changing consistency may be attained by full fluid diet, clear liquid diet and soft and mechanically soft diets. First, we are going to the full fluid diet. These are the full fluid or the fluid diets are classified into two: clear fluid diet and full fluid diet. In the clear fluid diet, a clear fluid is without any fiber content, without any solid portions. Clear fluid are provided, that is seen in the picture itself. It's a clear fluid. That is a clear fluid diet. It is usually used for 1 or 2 days after the surgery conditions or in a demanding situation only. Clear fluid diet is provided. It is followed for 1 or 2 days only. More than that, it is not recommended. After that, it is moved to the liquid diet with solids. Then it is moved to the soft diet and it proceeds like that. But the clear fluid diet is only prescribed for 1 or 2 days. Example for full fluid diets and clear fluid diets are the cereal waters, broths, lemon tea, coffee with herbs, etc. are the example of clear fluid diets. The diet is used after the surgery condition and the gastrointestinal disturbances. Next is the full fluid diet. Full fluid diet is composed of solids which liquid, and these solids must be easily digestible. Soups are example for the full fluid diet. This must be free from cellulose, or the fiber content is very low. There must not be any irritating condiments or spices, but it must contain high protein and high calorie. This diet must give all the required quantities of carbohydrates and proteins and other vitamins and minerals, but it must be in a liquid consistency. It is an intermediate between the clear fluid diet and the soft diet. The first, the clear fluid diet is given to during the surgery period. When the patient comes to a partially normal condition, from the clear fluid it changes to full fluid diet, and from the full fluid diet to a soft diet. It is the procedure of changes in the diet consistency. Example of full fluid diet are the half boiled eggs, vegetable soup, kheer, milk pudding, custards, etc. The diet is prescribed for after surgery conditions and the chewing problems and for the gastrointestinal disturbances. Then soft and bland diet. These are the two different types of diets. Bland diet is a mechanically non-irritant diet. Soft diet is easy to chewing, easily digestible. The diet contains all the required nutrients, all the proteins, vitamins, minerals and carbohydrates are in an adequate amount. But the consistency is soft, it is easily digestible and easy to chew and easy to digest. So these are the soft diets. All type of porridges comes under the soft diet. It is a non-irritant diet and it provides most of the proteins and carbohydrates. Most probably all these type of soft diet is included with milk or the egg portions to provide the proteins. Next is the bland diet. Bland diet is is almost like a soft diet, but the condiments and some spices are completely avoided. Fat content is completely avoided. And in general, it can be called as it is a physically, chemically and mechanically non-irritant diet. Most of the time, the method of cooking followed is steaming method. The fat used is meal and most of the spices and condiments are completely avoided. And it is devoid of all the undigested portions like heavy foods, like fats and that type of things are completely avoided from the bland diet. And it is provided in a room temperature, not too hot, not too cold. In a normal room temperature, it is provided without spices and without condiments, without fat. And it is very soothing to the stomach or the intestine. Most probably, it is used in the peptic ulcer situation. Then the rearrangement of meals, increasing or decreasing the frequency of meals, which you have studied in the pregnancy diet. We are increasing the frequency, but the meals are reduced. Then the same way in the disease condition also, for example, the fever condition, the diarrhea condition, the frequency is increased. The meals become so soft in a little quantity and a more digestible way. High amount of liquid is provided, but the number of meals are increased. That is an example for rearrangement of meals. Omission of foods. As we already discussed that in diabetic conditions, we are avoiding carbohydrate foods. In cardiovascular diseases, we are avoiding fatty foods. All these are examples of omission foods. Based on the specific conditions, their physiological conditions, certain foods are avoided to make the individual more healthy and comfortable.